Coming up next is Dalton SRL with Dishonored. Take it away, Dalton.
All right. So this is Dishonored. We load the game from a save because the beginning of the game is a really long cutscene and nobody wants to watch that. I'm going to explain something real quick before we get started because it's going to happen very quick. The thing you see me do is to skip a cutscene, and I'll explain how to do it in just a minute. Okay, so 3, 2, 1, go. So we skip around that guy and get going. So we are the Empress's bodyguard. My name is Corbo. And we like to just kind of climb walls because we can. So that thing I did right there is called an elevator. The way it works is that every 90 degree corner in the game has one pixel where you can vault all the way up. And so if you jump back into that and hold space, then you kind of just fly to the skies. And it's used a few times. It's used mostly before we get the main power of the run, which is what makes this run pretty broken. Elevators need a pretty high FPS because that's when it checks for how often you can vault up. So if you have a high enough FPS, then you can do the elevators much more consistently and in more places.
Corbo, 2 days early, full of surprises, as usual.
All right, so we have just returned from a trip. This is the Empress right here. Ooh, we got the Tivian chokehold. This is bound to be a good run. Thank you, Emily. All right, so coming up, we're gonna do another elevator. This one. So now we're just kind of walking along this fence right here. We can just kind of chill and go anywhere that the fence is going. So the reason that this is happening is because, lo and behold, that one guy that we talked to, he's not a very good guy. And so he hires some people to kill the Empress because who knows why. He wants to be in power. And so the people on the roof right there, these are the assassins. This is the tutorial bit. So if we jump off and take fall damage at the right time, we skip the tutorial because if you die during the tutorial, that's pretty embarrassing, to be honest. So the game just, they're like, well, they'll figure it out as they get going. So that's used to skip that. What I'm going to do up here during this cutscene, there's a skip kind of thing where it's called RE sequence skip. It was found by Ari. If you hold F during a cutscene and then don't push F or use, which is enter, into a F prompt. So like in the bottom left, you'll see the little circle thing where you hold F and it'll skip a cutscene. You'll see that coming up. So if I hit F during this cutscene and then through the loading zone, it'll just automatically skip that. Each one saves about 0.7 seconds.
Look at what he's
so,
done.
You know, the big time saves.
Yes, he's killed the Empress. What did you do with young lady Emily, traitor?
Yeah, dude, like, what kind of question is that? Where would I have put her?
I'll see you beheaded for this.
Like, where could she possibly go?
Peg him.
Yeah. Okay, so I just hit F right there, and I am going to continue to hold that. We have been dishonored. TM.
That's what that means.
Yeah. All right, so I'm still holding F, and if you look in the bottom left right there, you're going to see the little F prompt pop up. And there it goes. You saved 0.7 seconds. Thanks. All right, so we're in jail.
We should eat, Corvo.
Because
this meal comes from a friend.
We apparently killed the Empress. So obviously being in jail isn't too fun. So we're just gonna kind of leave.
Getting a few messages here in chat wondering why, what's up with the voices in this game?
That is a good question. They sound a bit high-pitched. I'm not entirely sure why. It makes it all that much more fun. So, in case you missed it, we just kind of escaped prison. We took the elevator. It really makes you think as to why people don't do that more often. If elevators have... I mean, if prisons have elevators, they can just kind of take them out. Like, I don't know. It just shows how much smarter we are than the common folk. So we are entering the sewers now.
Use some kind of explosive to blast his way out.
doesn't happen. Yeah, dude, the voices are really high pitched. I don't know why that's happening, but it's funny. So, yeah.
Some sort of new secret meme. All right. We got a couple of donations here. Mind if I go ahead and read those?
Give me just a minute. There's going to be a cutscene coming up.
Okay. All
right, so we jump into the river. Coming up right here, there's a bottle on the ground, and I missed it, so that's unfortunate. Now we have to, Corvo's going to be pretty upset. We have to touch the dead body when we could have just kind of thrown the bottle at it. Oh, got stuck in the wheel. Kind of wheel our way over. And coming up is going to be the last elevator of the run. These rats will attack you if you're not in a certain position. You can just kind of chill there and they won't do much. Oh, walls. Walls are hard. Right, so get another elevator. There's a chain there. Yeah. There's a chain there, but who wants to climb that? That's slow and physical exercise. So now some strangers have left us a crossbow and sword. This whole time, Corvo's just kind of going along with it. He's like, yeah, someone wants to give me weapons. Sure. That's okay. Okay, so I'm going to do a trick right there called Swordless. If you hold F to put away your weapons and then right-click while they're being put away, then you will continue to hold what is in your right hand, but you'll put your sword away. And okay, what the heck? Go. So that's good because while your sword's out, you move 10% slower. And so Swordless is a very, very useful thing. What? I hit the wire. Okay, so that's a speaker there, and if you shoot the wire, then the speaker will fall, and it'll explode and give you a damage boost.
I'm Samuel.
Yeah. And I work with some good people. So that's Samuel.
They said you'd come out here.
Wow, these voices are odd. This is going to be a wild ride. No. I don't know why they're high-pitched, but yeah. Okay. So Corvo's just kind of like... Corvo's like, well, there's this random man here who apparently gave me weapons. Better than prison. Yep. So he decides to go along with it. If you want to go ahead and read some donations, you can.
Alrighty, so...
This is the Hound Pits Pub.
First, we have we have $35 spread over two donations from Alucard X60, who says, you could say this character is in Sora need of improvement. We have $25 request from Grand Pooh Bear, who had this is from the Kirby round a minute ago, and asked, can Shasta point at the camp and smile? And now that you've escaped, the Lord Regent is going to be. He's coming up.
Oh, finger guns? Is that what we're doing?
Take you up to meet Admiral. We have $100 from Original MES. Says, it's great to see how much Californiathon has grown in just 1 year. I'm sad I couldn't make it this year, but I wish everyone the best. Thank you, Original.
Alright, so coming up right here is Corvo's finally going to meet the people that broke him out of prison, who installed the elevators to break out of prison. So we're going to work our way in here and pick up some money along the way because we're going to need to do some shopping, as all the great assassins of the world do. I saw you at court. Okay, so there's another sequence skip. And we take that, because stairs are hard, nobody wants to use them.
Perfect. Tell me what I can make.
Alright, so coming up.
You must be exhausted.
His voice is already funny enough, it just makes it so much better. Your life is getting. Okay, so coming up, I have a cheater mouse, which has a free scroll wheel, and I have down scrolls bound to jump.
Sleep well.
And if you input jump as this fades to the next loading screen, then the game freaks out and sets you to a neutral position, which saves some time of us running out the door of the bedroom and up the stairs. So this is Blink. This is what makes this run broken and fun. We can just kind of teleport, and it's kind of wild. And all the blue potions we're picking up are mana potions. Every time we use them, it refills our mana a bit. As to be expected.
Mana potion.
There's a potion in there. Nope, there we go. So this is just the like tutorial dream sequence. And the outsider. That was the outsider. We kind of talked to him for just a second. He's a interesting fella. So these are runes. They're what is used to upgrade our magic abilities.
How you you?
There's he is again, but we don't really care about what he has to say. We talked to him a few times. So you can pull your sword out there. If you click through the next screen, which is odd and doesn't really happen much other places. But we're going to do swordless again right here, because swords are slow. And we're going to pick up money to continue our shopping expeditions.
What can I do for you?
So we're going to buy one rune. Ooh, this mouse sensitivity is really high. Okay. We're going to buy a rune, a bunch of mana potions, and a grenade, which is a backup for bad RNG in a later mission. Right. Callista's kind of the worst. She gets in the way way too often.
Just give the signal.
She's not even useful.
She's not.
She wastes time.
Yeah, really. What she said right there is, hey, this guy that you're gonna go kill, he wants to kill my uncle, so how about he doesn't do that? And then we just kind of ignore her. If there are any more donations, feel free to read them during these very, very interesting Samuel Bow rides.
Alright, so first just want to plug some of the upcoming incentives. So the next upcoming incentive is a character choice bid warp for the bouncer between Ko, Vault, and Sion. And none of those have been met, but or none of those have raised any money so far, but feel free to donate towards one of those for the character of your choice. We also have a glitch exhibition in Mario & Luigi Superstar Saga. It's $61 from getting met. I assure you, you're going to want to see that. You're never going to look at a barrel the same way again.
That's pretty crazy. Alright, so this is the first mission of the game, Lord Campbell. So here's where you start saying that Blink's kind of broken. That's a double blink, which you blink twice before hitting the ground. That's easy. Shout out to Dr. T-Chops. He gets mad at me when I miss it. No, it's easy. Saves a second, so direct chops.
Congrats on your second.
Yeah, dude. So, a lot of the times when you see me fall, I'm trying to do what's called a, it's like a hard fall skip. If you fall in a certain range of height, then you will hit the ground and have the really long animation. I'll explain that in a sec. I'm going to explain hard falls. Corvo can just kind of walk through walls because he wants to. But the hard falls, if you... The hard falls, you can reach a certain range where you won't take damage, or you'll take damage, but you won't get the animation, and that's what it is. That's what we strive for. So Samuel's here. This is the only useful part, is we just kind of jump on his head, but we crouch. So obviously that lessens our weight to where it doesn't hurt him.
Men of the faith.
Or you.
Or me. Yeah, that's the most important part.
Ready to go.
Wait, dude, the voices aren't synced up with the dialogue. What? With the mouth. This is so weird. Okay. So the thing where I just kind of walk through walls, that's important, I guess. That is what's called a slip clip. What happens is if you lean left or right and then run into the door, then your head will kind of like peek through the other side of the door, because that's how physics works. And so while your head is sticking through this solid object, if you move the mouse to that side a little bit, then you can like move your mouse and then your crosshair will be able to blink. And I guess other stuff if you want to like shoot through a door, but they're all, I don't know, that seems pretty useless. I did another sequence skip there. I'm not gonna point out every time I do that. Y'all should have the hang of it by now. So this is the longer intermission. This is about weepers. We go into the sewers and take care of the problem. I hate practicing this because Piero says, "I know the golden cat," every single time, and it's very annoying. So yeah, same as slip clips, we can just kind of grab the keys through the walls because physics. So just picking up some runes, and here we're gonna upgrade the ability. Please don't crash. Thank you. I'm the only person that Chops makes fun of me because my game crashes there sometimes. And he's like, "Dude, it doesn't crash." And I'm like, "It's crashed like 5 times for me." He's like, "I don't know what to tell you."
He has news.
Shout out to Chops.
Never cease to amaze.
That was good. The Weepers they kind of move around. They move in a set pattern, but if you don't get there fast enough, then the pattern is kind of wonky. And if you really don't get there fast enough, which is something that I had a lot of trouble with when I first started learning the game, then Callista will be standing right in the doorway, which just furthers my hatred for her. Because all she does is listen.
I'll get you as close as I can to the golden cat.
Dude, she does nothing.
You'll have to go the rest of the way on your own.
Alright, so this is the first instance of RNG. This is a good run. I really like this run because it is both action-packed and fast-paced. And there is very minimal RNG. There's this one right here, which is a difference of like 1 or 2 seconds, I think. And then one of the later missions, which is about 10 to 15 seconds. And that's pretty much it. Other than that, it's like whether or not guards will shoot you or not. So this is the same location that our last mission was in, which is the only time that happens. Most of the time when we're blinking at a ledge, I try to line it up to where I'll get, it's like an instant climb. I may have done something there, we'll see. If you mash F on that door, then it'll like store the loading zone, and so when I come back out, the little prompt will pop up, so we will see. So Emily is taken captive, so we're like, hey Emily. And then she goes back to Samuel,
I heard you there.
Which is, she's significantly faster than we are, so real talk, she should look into a future of speedrunning. Okay, so those little red lights right there signify the RNG. I got the better of the two RNG patterns, which means I don't get to show off the cool grenade clip. That didn't kill him, which was interesting. Now we get to see him. Very... Oh, goodness. Hey, guys. Hey, can you just move a little bit? Hey, thank you.
Check on.
Oh, yep. Oh, he didn't die. What is with this? They're very resilient today. There we go. Oh my goodness. Okay, there we go. Alright, so now, here is Emily. Hey, Emily. So we go through it. And then she's just already at the boat. She's just already there, so. I don't know what we're doing, but we need to take some pointers from Emily. Dude, I don't even want to know. It'll just make me feel worse about myself. Yeah.
Are you both ready to go?
Wait, his voice is normal here.
Corvo, you must
no, it's not. I lied. Something that frustrates me about this game is, like, there, as soon as I said yes, he's like, you ready to go back? And I'm like, yeah. Then the level instantly ends. But sometimes he's like, do you want to go back? And I say yes. And then there's just, like, 15 seconds of black screen.
Did you, Corvo?
So.
I'm not one to speak against my
veterans. I wish it was consistent.
If anybody ever deserved their fate, it was those penalties.
This is, I enjoy this line because Samuel gets really uncomfortable.
What business are you talking about?
Wow, her voice is almost
grown up business girl.
This is wild.
I mean, your ladyship.
I need to figure out how to recreate this.
You'll have to recreate all the tech problems.
I heard a lot of business at the Golden
Tower. Oh, dude, setting this run up, oh my goodness. It was
not even just like 5 minutes before this, but the entire past 24 hours.
I'm glad I figured out how to do it before the run, because I was just kind of coming into it. I'm like, I'll just plug the flash drive in and restore from there and we'll be good to go. I was up for like 4 hours yesterday trying to figure out how to get all the saves and stuff to work. And, dude, shout out to TeamViewer. Y'all don't know what that program is. I was using my phone to access my computer at home, and that allowed me to transfer all the files I needed through Discord. And as I was leaving, I was going to the airport.
Can I see it?
And I was like, should I leave TeamViewer up? Should I leave my computer on? I was like, I'm probably not going to need it, but I'm very glad that I left it on. Because I very much so needed it.
I'll go with Callista, Corvo.
So.
I'll see you later.
Oh, bye, Emily.
And here's Callista.
Oh, bye, Callista.
Have time for another donation?
Yeah, go for it.
All right. And with the Pendleton twins gone. A couple more donations, actually. We got one from a Wild Abra. It says, Dalton, get world record already.
Dude, no. In one night. Dude, Henny has record. Henny's a robot. He's crazy. No, dude. But for
now. We have another $20 from Purple Mudkip 7 saying, hey Dalton, good luck with the run. Please try not to shoot Samuel in the face this time.
Okay, but, see, also, when I left the sewers, I shot him in, like, the thigh. One time I shot him in the head, and that all right. very much so killed him.
And that just ends the run. You just...
He also leaves a note saying, by the way, I'm better at Smash.
Well, we'll get our sleep later. You're not, but we'll take that up later. That's a later point. Climb aboard when you're ready. I didn't know it was possible to kill him, because every time people shot him, I was like, okay, he's invincible. And then that was swiftly disproven. Okay, so here
what
is,
do you think,
I need to wait at the first door, because if you go too fast, then you'll soft lock the game, which I've done a lot. So I'm going to try my best not to. It's very, very easy to do, because you just stand there for a second.
That's right. We'll be spotted for sure.
But it feels slow.
You're gonna have
it's not in my
power
nature.
Before I can pick you up. Now, about bringing Sokolov.
It kind of. This is the one mission. This is the first mission where we don't. Our target isn't to kill someone.
New technology.
So now the game's getting more family friendly. But what do I instead, know? Just shoot him with a sleep dart. Alright, so. This is Caldwin's Bridge. Another slip clip right up here because walls just don't exist. This door right up here is the one where I have to wait because if you enter it before this little prompt pops up, then you soft lock the game. You can exit and re enter, but I'm very oblivious because I'm like, I wouldn't do that. And so by the time I realize it, I'm already at like the end of the level. And then I realize that I killed a run and I cry.
I want to go ahead and say, so we are getting donations. We are reading them, even if we haven't quite said them out on stream yet. So go ahead and keep donating. So Direct Relief is a charity that Californiathon is for the benefit of. It's a charity that helps people who need help because of poverty, disasters, or other sorts of emergencies, and quickly deliver essential medical resources.
Alright, so something that happened back there, when I blinked and then I ran into the flag, that was actually very useful because I'm supposed to do a double blink, but the double jump didn't activate. And so because this game runs at a high FPS, because Bethesda is wonderful at making video games, hold on, there we go. Forgot what I was saying. Oh, I blinked into the flag and I just kind of stuck to it, and so I didn't take any fall damage, which was very good. So. Yeah, shoutouts to Bethesda for A-plus games. They didn't even make this game, they just published it. Anything they get their hands on turns out to be a video game. I'll go with that.
Makes it.
Okay. Like, if any of y'all have seen the new Skyrim route, you get on a horse, and then you tilt the horse, and then you fly through the air. Because Bethesda.
But from what I hear, he's woken up worse places. As we all have at that.
If you have another donation.
Doesn't look like we have any new donations, but we'll plug a couple more incentives. So, after Superstar Saga, we also have. I'd like to point out that the Reverie Mumradora 4 Reverie Under the Moonlight handheld percent with Vulligin has been met. You're going to enjoy that. It's going to be adorable. Also, on top of that, we have East Origin, which is unlock the ultimate flashy attack. If any of you are fans of Dragon Ball Z, you're going to want to see that. I mean, we are, after all, sponsored by AOD, an anime convention here in Santa Clara.
Small thing, those sleep darts on that desk right there, sometimes they just kind of don't exist, and I can't figure out why. But also, every time I ask about them, nobody else seems to have that problem.
You're part of this room.
It's just me, like crashing.
And high pitched voices.
I hear you're off to the board. You'll know it.
His voice is already obnoxious enough. Okay, so we get a letter there, and he's like, "Hey, there's this dude there, and he's kind of awful. So I want you to fight him, but that's slow, so we don't fight him." This is the big point of RNG in the run. Nobody really understands how it works, except for Mumrick, probably. It's very interesting. So there are three boils. There's one correct one that we have to kill. There are three possible bedrooms for the note to spawn in. So there's one right where we enter. So we kill that boil regardless. And then if we're in the one of third room, then we check that note. And if that note matches the one in third boil that we killed, then cool. But if it doesn't, then we have to go kill the correct one. If we're in the two-thirds room that isn't the correct one, there are notes that are spawned out of bounds. And so if we pick up one of the three notes that's correct, then we also can just leave. But if we don't, then the game freaks out, so we just have to kill all three of them. Alright, so we did not get a good room. Did we get a good note? Hey, cool. So that is equivalent to the best RNG. So that's good. Because I hate this.
They told me not to let anyone up here.
What the heck? Oh, so there's a plant right there. It's a the hitbox extends to like twice the height of the plant. It's very dumb. Alright. Hey Samuel.
I hope you enjoyed your evening, sir. Wait, that's me on my way. Quick.
Yeah, so this is one where it's like, yeah, and then it's like, well, any day now. There you go.
Just want you to look at Samuel's face.
He just, he wants to have a heartfelt moment on the boat in the river. He's sad he doesn't get to spend that much time with us. Yeah, so that RNG is kind of fluctuating, and it's frustrating.
I checked the wine
because
cellar.
You have to go through
gives a man a
like the rest of the manor and kill the other two, and one of them can be in any of like three rooms, and sometimes they're just in the middle of the hallway, and sometimes they're in nowhere that they should be, and so it's frustrating.
Right. And those reset like a marathon. It's just awful.
Yeah. All right. So
you did it.
Normally, that's my favorite line of the game, because when you blink, what's really happening is, like, time slows down and you actually move, so it looks like you're teleporting. So normally, when I blink there and talk to him, when he says, you did it, his voice is really low and it's funny, but now it just sounded normal. So, it was less interesting. That is a good question.
Corvo,
adjacent to Boyle
Manor, remain
off limits.
No, ready to face the Lord Regent?
About time. Can we just took care admire of Samuel's shoes?
Long past time.
They're real good.
Have time for another donation?
Oh, I'm gonna explain one thing real quick. So when we talked to Pendleton right there, so we gave that guy the note, and he read it, and he's like, Pendleton's a gutless, lying sack of
last
expletive.
Might not be good ones,
right? So if we maybe fought him and then we won, then when we talked to Pendleton, he would be like, wow, you did a great job. But if we
most
didn't give him the note,
the Lord,
then Pendleton would be like, what the heck, dude? Why didn't you do that? But if we give him the
also
note and then just leave, then he just kind of doesn't mention it. Which is faster. Because he talks for forever on both of the things that... with a bit, like,
broadcast control
options,
station here, where all them announcements come from.
You can go ahead and read it.
Alright. So, we got a $20 donation from Blakester, saying, doing some, a little bit of trash talk, and saying, yeah, I'm better than Dalton and Purple Mudkip at Smash, so y'all can eat rocks. Good luck on the rest of the run, Dalton. And with that, we have just hit $700. Thank you very much, everybody.
Okay.
Want to go ahead and give a big shout out to everyone who's been hosting us. We've gotten quite a few hosts, both offline and people from the stream. So thank you very much.
I was gonna hit that.
Really appreciate it.
So that was the last elevator that we see. It's just easy to climb to the top of the water lock. All right. So more so that walls just don't exist. We just kind of want to rob them, so we do that. This is when Samuel's like, oh, the next time I talk to you, Lord Pendleton, or the Lord Regent will be dead. But we take that, and that's him confessing to doing bad things, and so we play it for the entire city to hear, and they get mad.
Oh,
there we go.
Where are you, Prowler?
Attention, Dunwall Tower.
So Corvo just likes going flying through the air. Alright, and I ended with one blink left, which is
ready to go back to the Hound Pit?
Good. Ideally, you're supposed to end there with no blinks left.
Thanks to you, Corvo.
And no potions.
Alright, let's go.
Because after this, you don't have any potions. And so it is optimal to end there with zero blinks, zero potions, and zero health potions. But the health potions don't really matter because you don't use them if you don't need them.
Makes me uneasy, to tell the truth.
Yeah, that was pretty awful first part of the game.
But maybe it's going to be different now.
So we took care of the Lord Regent. It was good. So we're about to be re-honored,
the others are in the bar. No doubt.
Because first we were dishonored.
Glass in your name.
And now the goal of the Loyalists was to re-honor us.
Reflect on things.
And so we've achieved that. Honored. Well, if we had honor, because we were the Empress's bodyguard, so we already had honor.
And we were dishonored.
Re-honored. Alright, so Emily gets in the way because why wouldn't she? So now he's like, hey, you've done a lot, go to bed. And we're like, okay. So we go to bed. But lo and behold, maybe this might surprise all of you. I know it did me the first time I played the game. But those guys that told you to go around killing a bunch of people, they may not be the best guys. So we got poisoned. So we have been re-dishonored. Okay, so this is the longest cutscene, and right after those two F-prompts, so he's like, Samuel, you move like you've been drinking. And so those two F-prompts, I hold F. And I have to hold F through the entirety of this cutscene to save 0.7 seconds. Because fast. This game runs on... We have a loadless timer, so it removes load times. Because different hard drives and solid-state drives will load the game faster. So for my personal runs, my RTA times are about a minute and 10 seconds slower than my loadless times. It varies from person to person. So if there's donations, I'm going to go for that.
Oh, right after you donate for that. Or right after you mentioned that, we got a donation from Wild Mouse for $30 with no comment. Thank you very much for your donation. I'd just like to point out that Blakester has been talking trash in chat.
If it helps him feel better. Yeah. Okay. So, here comes... This is Doubt.
Great deal, bodyguard.
He sounds significantly more intimidating than the voice file.
I recognize the marks on your hand.
So
a gift from your friend.
He is also visited.
The one who talks to you in the dark.
Outsider. The
talks to you when you visit his shrines.
Decided to give us magical powers.
I visited those shrines too.
He decides to throw all of our equipment away, which is why if we had any potions, then
but
we
I don't
wouldn't
know
have potions now.
Who you are?
There's a small percent chance that he just kind of turns around and throws them the other way. So if we're really lucky, that might happen. But it did not. He just kind of turns around and like throws them onto the catwalk. This guy is pretty cool. He punches us without moving his arms. So I was holding F through the entirety of that cutscene, and cool, 0.7 seconds has been saved. Alright, so this is the longest mission of the game, the Flooded District. And it has three slip clips, which are all different timings from one another, and they are all collectively different timings than all of the other ones in the game. So it's a wild ride. And it's also the longest and most difficult, so we're gonna see how this goes. So we get locked in here, everything's taken away from us except for our mask, which I talk about a lot. So normally you're supposed to take some bricks on the floor and throw them at the grate, but that's slow, and so we just kind of walk out, and there's some potions there. You're supposed to pick up the sword, but like I said, 10% slower, and you don't really need it. Also, that sword's weird. You can't do swordless with it unless you do some weird, like, melee something or other. So it's just faster to not pick it up. So we're now out of bounds, and... Ooh, I had a... Okay, I'm gonna swim, because I blinked into a wall that I didn't know existed. There we go. Nope, that's not what I wanted. There we go. Alright, so Dowd, normally we would talk to him, but that actually saves a significant amount of time, and we spared him. Apparently. Because we certainly didn't kill him, and that's the only other option. So, here we go. I double jump here to get to skip the hard fall and do the damage cancel. And last slip clip of the run. That's a lie. Second to last. Last one of flooded, though. This door is twice as thick as all the other ones, and so it's kind of real finicky if you want to get on the other side of it. There we go. Alright, so we jump into the river here, and if you quick save and quick load, then the game's like, he probably swam the whole way, and so it sticks us at the end. And we're still out of bounds. And then going inbounds is super slow, so we're gonna walk, and then we're done with flooded. That was actually a really good flooded, so that's cool. Half-hearted claps. Alright, so now we're back at the Hound Pits. And we're like, dude, what the heck? Why did you poison me? You're so rude. But the dudes are not here. They have escaped to their their safe haven. Okay, this is another last clip, which is also a different kind of the rest.
What was that?
Okay.
What the void was that?
You don't need slip clips.
Corvo, I can't believe you're alive.
And here's Callista, of course. Why would she be anywhere else? The good thing about picking up the sword, if you do pick it up, is that you can get mad at Callista. And then there's no loyalist conspiracy to disband, so you won't get in trouble for it. Alright, so another thing right here. We blink off the boat, so we can go here, and if you quick save
one more trip
and quick load, then it skips his dialogue, and we fade in, and we are headed towards the last level of the game, King Sparrow Isle, which is a giant lighthouse. So Sandy's been pretty cool. He's been driving us around places. He's been a homie all the way, and he was the only one who truly believed in us.
They're not giving up without a fight.
Because he was the one that poisoned us, but he used a lesser dose, so we would not.
So we wouldn't die.
So that's a pretty good thing.
Going in has to breach the floor, the gatehouse.
However,
one way to the top.
Throughout the rest of the game, if you hurt any member of the loyalist conspiracy, then it says that it has been disbanded, and you get a game over. However, because the loyalist conspiracy has already seemed to have been disbanded, considering that all of its members ran away. It's kind of hard to have a committee with nobody there. We're just gonna kind of like, I appreciate it, Samuel, but you talk way too much. So we get one more double blink there, just across that. That guard was good, he wasn't in the way, so I didn't get zapped and died. I didn't get a hole in one, but I fell in. As good as can be expected. I've lost runs to not being able to get in the hatch on the elevator because it has a very small hitbox. Hey, so shoutouts to actual elevators. That's pretty cool. Okay, so time will be coming up when I interact with Emily's door. I'll call it out. It'll be in about a minute.
Real quick, before we get to that, we got one last donation here. It says, like, $20 by Chillin' Dude. It says, I'm better than all you fools, and I got 5-0'd.
Just shout out to Chillin'. Alright, so we pick up a key. There, everyone, time.
Alright,
cool.
Yeah.
Is everyone okay now?
It was, you know, it doesn't matter. Okay, so Emily's here, and she's like, hey, do I get to be Empress now? Even though she's like 12. It's like, yeah, sure, go for it.
So ends the interregnum.
Here we get the outsider
and
his
Emily Caldwin the first
balloon voice.
Take her mother's throne.
So yeah, that is Dishonored. If anybody has any
you will stand
interest
at her side
in some other
her,
runners, Dr. T-Chops, Henny K,
protecting her from those who seek to exploit
Mr. Walrus, Fearful Ferret. Yeah, a bunch of the crew. There's a very expansive guide on the speedrun.com page. Yeah, it's a really cool game. I recommend
you watched and listened when other men would have shouted
yeah,
in rage.
Good to go.
You held back. So it ends with the passing of the player of the magnificent king.
Thank you very much for that. Dishonored run. Right, coming up next, we've got The Bouncer by TurboDog702. Just stick around.